Now the next topic is about center of mass of distributed point masses. Look at here, they are all different masses, they are all called as point masses. They are distributed in the space. Mass m1, m2, m3, m4, they are all separate masses, they are all point masses. They are negligibly small and they will occupy very small space. Their mass is very negligible. Such kind of masses, they are all called point masses. Here, though they are distributed in the space, for all masses we can point out one center of mass. So this is the location of the center of mass. Approximately I have taken, this one may be the location of the center of mass. The center of mass is represented by the letter Cm. Okay. Here, these masses, they are taken, they are assumed that they are in the three-dimensional coordinate system. Are you clear? So here n number of masses are there, just I have taken 4 masses alone for explaining this concept. For these n number of masses, we have to find out where is the center of mass is located, the 3 coordinates of the center of mass, xcm, ycm, zcm to be found out. The expression for xcm, expression for ycm, expression for zcm to be derived now. What is xcm? xcm is nothing but x coordinate of the center of mass. ycm means y coordinate of the center of mass. zcm means z coordinate of the center of mass to be found out. Several number of masses are there. Their center of mass is approximately located here in the center of geometric center of all the masses. There its coordinate to be found out. Here, the thing is, first we'll find out xcm. How to find out xcm? What is xcm? xcm means x coordinate of the center of mass. For that, first we have to find out the individual coordinates of the masses. For mass m1, x1 is a coordinate in the x-axis. For m2 mass, x2 is the coordinate with respect to x-axis. For m3 mass, x3 is the coordinate with respect to x-axis. For m4, x4 is the coordinate for m4 along x-axis. So how to find out the xcm? What is the formula? Look at the formula. Xcm, that is center of mass, particularly its coordinate along x-axis. Okay, so xcm means x coordinate of the center of mass. How to find out? What we have to do now? We have to find out the product. M1 to be multiplied with x1, m2 to be multiplied with x2, m3 to be multiplied with x3, m4 to be multiplied with x4. The product values to be added. If n number of particles are there, all the product values to be found out. Mass and distance, mass and coordinate, mass and coordinate, mass and respective coordinates to be multiplied, all the values to be summated, all the values to be added. That is to be divided by the sum of all the masses, m1, m2, m3. If n number of masses are there, all masses to be added. So this one can be written in this form. Summation of, what is sigma? Sigma is nothing but summation of these products to be added. That is written like this. Summation of mi, xi. Instead of I, we can substitute 1. Instead of I, we can substitute 2. Instead of I, we can substitute 3. If all are added, if all product values are added, you will get this expression. Later, summation of all the masses to be found out. That is written as sigma mi. Sigma mi means sum of all the masses. This formula that gives you the value of xcm. Here that xcm is located. What is xcm? This is the xcm is nothing but x coordinate of the center of mass. That is exactly located here. Are you clear? This is the formula from which we are able to find out xcm. The same center of mass, it is having ycm and zcm also. How to find out ycm? I'll write the formula. YCM can be found out with the help of the same thing. Instead of x1, we have to write y1, m1, y1, m2, y2, m3, y3. Each mass, they are having their y coordinate also. M1 is having its y coordinate y1, m2 is having its y coordinate y2, m3 is having its y coordinate y3, the nth mass, that nth mass is having its coordinate along y-axis. Everything to be added. So clear. After finding out the product, you have to add everything. You will get the summation. Okay. All masses m from right from m1, m2, nth mass, all masses to be added. You will get the summation of all masses. That one gives you which one? YCM. If this one could be written, this entire format can be written in this form. How will you write? YCM is equal to sigma mi. Instead of x, we have to write yi divided by sigma mi can be written. So this is the formula to find out xcm. This is the formula to find out ycm. ycm may be approximately here. Okay, if you draw a line here, right from here, you are able to locate the which one? ycm, center of mass, y coordinate can be found out. Xcm is found out, ycm is found out. Like that, we can write the expression for the zcm also. How will you write the expression for zcm? Sigma mi, so clear, z I can be written divided by sigma m I can be written. So three formulas, xcm, ycm, zcm, all the three, so clear, they give the values of the three coordinates of the center of mass. Okay, though the point masses are distributed in the space, all the masses, they have their own center of mass. That one may lie approximately at the center of all the masses. Are you clear? Here two masses are there, here two masses are there. Approximately the center of mass, it has to lie here. Are you clear? Its x coordinate is xcm. The center of mass y coordinate is ycm. Are you clear? Along the z direction also, we are able to find out one more coordinate, that is zcm. These three formulas, they give the values of xcm, ycm and zcm. Okay.